الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفوته من خلقه وحبيبه قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وجاهد في سبيل دينه حتى أتاه اليقين فاللهم اجزه عنا وعن والدينا وعن الإسلام والمسلمين خير ما جزيت به نبيا عن قومه ورسولا عن أمته اللهم أحينا على سنته وآمتنا على ملته واحشرنا تحت لوائه وأوردنا حوضه واسقنا من يده الشريفة شربة هنيئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا. Brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appointed those who believe in Him as commissioners on pay. Commissioners means people who are commissioned by Allah, commanded by Allah for one mission only. After believing in Allah, we need to submit to His orders. And after we submit to His orders, we are required to fix what is broken in the human life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala meant this life to be a good life. فَلَنُحْيِيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبَةً. طَيِّبَةً means life without suffering, life without fights, life without pain. And if something goes wrong, he has been and has always been the backer of anybody who is afflicted as a result of qada and qadr. So you bring pain on yourself, you better fix it. If you bring trouble to yourself, you better do your best to fix it. Even if you are tested by Allah with something difficult, you still need to do your best to fix what is broken. Human lives have been broken for centuries, if not longer. And as Allah describes the humans as one family, كلكم لآدم وآدم من تراب. You all belong to Adam, you all go back to Adam, and Adam comes from dust. He is talking to us as one family. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ إِنَّا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ وَأُنْثَى One family. وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلَ لِتَعَارَفُوا إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ O mankind, we've created you from a single pair of a male and female, and we've made you into peoples and tribes so that you may know, not despise, so that you may get to know each other, get to help each other. So humanity is given the gift of being one family, coming literally from one man and one woman, literally. There is no discussion about it. Why? I want to get or borrow the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who describes the believers as one body. We all know the hadith. What does it say? The believers to one another is like one body. If one part aches, the whole of the body suffers. Humanity, being one family, is subject to the same. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whenever He created any living thing, He instituted in His creation the self-defense mechanism against attacks, against disease, which we call the immune system. Where I'm going with this? I'm going to Surah Al-Imran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us as believers, كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس. You have been the best of nations ever sent out to mankind. You are the immune system. You are the defense mechanism against corruption, against aggression, against injustice, against devaluing the values that Allah created us with in our fitrah. Our role is to protect those values. And the point in this issue is, a couple of nights ago, I read in several sources that there is a man, I don't recall his last name, but his first name is Robert. I don't know if you also have got the story. Robert has a 13-year-old girl. His daughter, he's Canadian, his daughter told him, Daddy, I want to change my gender. I want to be a boy. And as a dad, he started to talk to her, telling her, daughter, honey, that is gonna go against your nature. God gave you a beautiful body, beautiful soul. You are this, you are that. But she wouldn't budge. I want to do it. Somewhere, somehow, she picked the idea either directly from the shaitan or from a human shaitan who told her, you will be better changing into a boy. Up to here, it's a family struggle. Anyone could face it with their family. Kids are kids. She is 13 years old. She wants to maybe be like her brother, maybe like her cousin. Maybe she sees boys are getting away with things and she wants to be a boy. That's not in the story. Those background potential issues are not written in the story. But what's written will shock you. The school picked her desire, and on her behalf, they bring her, quote unquote, counselors to help her achieve her goal. They take her to a doctor, and the doctor injects her with testosterone, the male hormones, to help her grow hair and look like more of a boy than a girl. The change of the creation of Allah is mentioned in the Quran as one of the things the shaitan vowed to persuade us to do it and to make us do it. This is not only known in the Quran, it is known in the Bible as well. So this is not a unique issue to Islam. Mind you, few days ago, not an imam, not the Sheikh of Al-Azhar, but none other than Pope Francis said that as a matter of religion, we can never support or acknowledge homosexuality. So let's not blame each other. Why do you bring this issue? The issue is on the table. It has been on the table for decades now. So, as we all know, there are forces that are pushing humanity into this direction, and they call it liberation or libertarian. What should be humans liberated from is where they are suffocating every human being. We should be free from occupation. We should be free from manipulation. We should be free from cheating each other. We should be free from injustices. But they leave all of this and they reduce all the human rights, is the right to deviate from your own nature that Allah created you to be. Allah told us in the Quran and in the Bible that He has created us in males and females. He told us the wisdom behind this. We wouldn't have families. You wouldn't have humanities if people only want to enjoy a sexual relationship that has nothing to do with their nature or how Allah created them. So the Quran explains to us what Allah wants and what people who are following their whims want. يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُبَيِّنَ لَكُمْ وَيَهْدِيَكُمْ سُنَنَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَيَتُوبَ عَلَيْكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ وَاللَّهُ يُرِيدُ أَنْ يَتُوبَ عَلَيْكُمْ وَيُرِيدُ الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الشَّهَوَاتِ أَنْ تَمِيلُوا مَيْلًا عَظِيمًا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ أَنْ يُخَفِّفَ عَنْكُمْ وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا. What Allah wants is to shower us with His mercy, through His guidance, through His blessings and bounties, through His care, through His attention to everything we do, small and large. So Allah is always there for His creation. But the question is not where is Allah, the question is where are we from Allah? But that question nobody wants to ask. Because the assumption is we're doing all what we can, which we're not doing it, but we presume that we are, and specifically as Muslims, you are the immune system. If you do not push back against foreign bodies, foreign in the sense that they want to change the fitra of humanity, they want to change the nature of humanity. As Satan himself told Allah, I will persuade them to be harsh-hearted even with animals. And I will persuade them to change the creation of Allah. We used to think that shaving eyebrow is a change of the creation of Allah. We used to think that if a man dresses like a woman or a woman dresses like a man, that this is a change of the creation of Allah. But it has got new meanings. The more Allah gifts humanities with ways and means to manipulate whatever Allah provided them of blessings, the more wicked and deviant we become. Unless we become the forces of correction. Wait for what Allah has told us would eventually happen, and it has already happened. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, وَلَوْلَا دَفْعُ اللَّهِ النَّاسَ بَعْضَهُمْ بِبَعْضٍ لَفَسَدَتِ الْأَرْضِ. Will it not for Allah pushing people, you are going to do it, pushing people against each other, people who carry truth are pushed against others, people who carry and promote falsehood, they are also pushed by the shaitan against others. This fight is ours. We should not be watching a movie. Robots should not be waiting for centuries for someone to come by. And he should never expect the current so-called liberal human rights organizations to come and defend his right. He should only wait for Muslim voices to come up and speak loud and say he has the right to raise his daughter the way he wants. Otherwise, there are questions about what the Canadian government did, and you didn't hear the rest of the story. The court issued a ruling against Robert. If you call her as a female, you will be sent in jail. I'm not trying to scare you. I'm presenting the reality as it comes to us from our neighbors in the north. So waiting is only going to make matters even worse for us. Recently, we know that the Supreme Court has already acknowledged homosexual marriage as a legal protected marriage. I don't know if a day will come that they will force people who have court license to perform marriages will be forced to marry homosexual marriages. Otherwise, you lose your license. Or parents who want to protect their daughters or boys from all of these hallucinations, they will be threatened with jail sentences. The question this issue raises is much more serious than I can make it in a few minutes. It is about the existence of humans with God-sent values vis-a-vis the rest of humanity taking over, and people who believe, like conservative Muslims, I wouldn't say conservative, I would say Muslims. It doesn't take a conservative Muslim to believe that. It doesn't take a conservative Muslim, but I would have to say a conservative Christian, a Muslim, a conservative Jew definitely disagree with all of these trends. But we are all becoming cornered as a minority opinion. Why? Because the louder voices is not ours. We are sitting on our hands, licking our lips, and hoping that some angel would come from heaven to change this. Allah already did send an angel, Angel Jibreel, and he told us what to do, coming from Allah. Why don't we do it? It is because it is in the neighborhood, it's not in my household. But brothers and sisters, I have seen situations right here in this masjid where some girls, alhamdulillah, that they are the few, they are the exceptional few, want to marry a non-Muslim friend. And after she turns 20 and 21 and beyond, how could you want to change her attitude or her mind? How do you reprogram somebody after that age? How do you redirect them? So this is not as far as Canada-US distance seems to make us believe. It is right in our neighborhood. And if the fire in the neighborhood, you better run and help before it comes to your home. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the courage to pick up the right issues on behalf of this community and on behalf of the Muslim community worldwide and on behalf of all godly people who want to live by godly values rather than being swept in the flood of liberal, outlandish, deviant values. Allahumma. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحابته ومن اتبع سنته بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وعنا معهم بفضلك يا أرحم الراحمين. Brothers and sisters, imagine if that same girl told her that, "Dad, I have a boyfriend, but I don't want to go as a girlfriend, I want to marry him." And he starts to tell her, "That's okay, if this is what you want." Right? Will the law, will human rights organizations come by and say, "Yes, she is mature, let her make up her mind. If this is the life she wants to have, let us support her, and you cannot stop her"? Will they? Let us say, if she wants to stop going to school, a matter as simple as education, But it is mandatory in her county to go to school. Can her father support her homeschooling? So the issue is not about human rights. The issue is about deviant rights. Because if it were really human rights, the millions of people in jail would have been out. But they are not. If it were about human rights, Palestine would have been free a long time ago. If it were about human rights, the Rohingya would not be in concentration camps today. So let's not deceive each other, but let us ask the practical question. What is the solution? The solution in the ayah I cited, وَلَوْلَا دَفْعُ اللَّهِ النَّاسَ بَعْضَهُمْ بِبَعْضٍ لَفَسَدَتِ الْأَرْضِ. If it were not for Allah pushing people against each other, the earth would have been full of corruption. It is on our shoulder to establish human rights organizations, if need be, that can work on behalf of our values. To tell Robert, you're not alone. You have the right to teach your daughter what you want. And the state has no right to step in your home. After all, when the church occupied the state revolted against the church, and the result is the international movement called the Protestant movement that started in Germany and moved like wildfire all throughout Europe. And it is the movement for which the United States was built, to establish freedom of religion, not freedom from religion. Anyone wants to be part of this, ask yourself, can you at least speak about not the issue of Robert, but the bigger issue of what do we want to be the values for our children and grandchildren, wherever they may be? What is the mechanism that we are going to push for to protect the values Allah created us to protect? What are we going to do as Muslims? If this is all what we can do, let us do it. If we need to set up 10, 20 human rights organizations to push back against the wildfire that is catching humanity, let us do it. But sitting silent is not an option. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among the best of nations that He meant us to be. Allahumma ahdina fi man hadayt, wa afina fi man afayt, wa tawallana fi man tawallayt, wa qina wa sarif anna sharra ma qadayt. Allahumma ahsin lana min khashyatika ma tahulu bihi baynana wa bayna ma'siyatik, wa min ta'atika ma tubalighuna bihi jannatak, wa min al-yaqin ma tuhawwinu bihi alayna masa'ib ad-dunya. ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقوتنا ما أحييتنا، واجعله الوارث منا، واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا، ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا، ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا، ولا مبلغ علمنا، ولا إلى النار مصيرنا. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم، فستذكرون ما أقول لكم، وأفوض أمري إلى الله. إن الله بصير بالعباد.